In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of rhomboid. Rhomboid is part of shoulder girdle muscle. It's on kind of an inside part of the scapula. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Let's get started. Sometimes rhomboid can be divided two parts. This one is rhomboid minor. Rhomboid minor, because it's smaller compared to the other muscle. This part is rhomboid major. But you can call this muscle as one muscle. This is rhomboid. You can say rhomboid minor and rhomboid major, or rhomboid. Okay, however you want to call it, people will understand you. Origin of rhomboid is this part, the cervical spine and thoracic spines. Right here, lower cervical spine to the middle part of the thoracic spine. Insertion is here, medial border of scapula, medial border. Medial border. Origin was here, cervical spine through the thoracic spine. So let's look at its function. So which direction does rhomboid pull the bones? This direction, right? So what happens if rhomboid pulls this way? That brings scapula this way. This movement is adduction. Adduction of scapula, or you can call this movement as retraction. Adduction and retraction mean same movement, kind of closing scapula towards thoracic spine. This is adduction. But if you look carefully, the direction of rhomboid, it's not completely horizontal, right? It's a little bit diagonal. That means rhomboid can pull scapula this way. What kind of movement can it make? It can make this kind of rotational movement of scapula. What is it? That is downward rotation. Downward rotation is this movement. So the function of rhomboid is adduction or retraction plus downward rotation. Downward rotation is very important for shoulder movement. You don't see shoulder, but imagine there is a shoulder and arm here. If rhomboid is very, very tight, scapula is brought to this way, right? This way. Then it stacks here. Then scapula cannot move very freely. If scapula does not move, shoulder cannot move. That's why downward rotation is very, very important for shoulder movement. Actually, the neighbor of rhomboid can do downward rotation as well. Which one is that? That's this one. This is levator scapula. Levator scapula. This muscle also can do downward rotation. So if levator scapula and rhomboid get tight, that can inhibit movement of shoulder. This rotational movement is so, so crucial for shoulder movement. Let's review anatomy of rhomboid. Okay, origin is cervical spine and thoracic spine. Insertion is medial border of scapula. If rhomboid pulls scapula this way, that makes adduction or retraction and downward rotation. By the way, it's important for shoulder movement. Levator scapula also can do downward rotations. In this video, I explain the basic anatomy of rhomboid. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.